Good afternoon, everyone. Today's topic is what I have covered is opportunity for asset management up to 15 plus gigawatt of installation. It will be a great opportunity for those who will do it with commitment in systematic and organized manner, give better and reliable service support, and create faith in customers. I want to share an example on this. I belong to Indore and Ujaas headquartered at Indore. Some of you might know that Indore has received cleanest city of India title in 2017. And this opportunity was converted into achievement by commitment, systematic approach, and connect with the stakeholder. Before advancing, let me familiarize you all with Ujaas Energy Limited. Ujaas has been in power sector since incorporation in 1979 as a part of backward integration from power transmission and distribution. We have started solar power generation. We are in ISO 9001 and 14001 certified company and listed in BSE and NSE in 2011. Ujaas has been felicitated by prestigious agencies like CARE, Economic Times, Business World, Forbes Asia. We are having presence in EPC and operation maintenance for ground mounted and rooftop, with a workforce of 450 plus employees located across the country. We pay special attention on operation maintenance with biggest and most efficient team of Ujaas. We executed projects across the country and touched all the corners, right from northern part to Andaman and Nicobar, where we have done 1 megawatt of rooftop and 150 kilowatt at Port Blair Airport. At Ujaas, we are equipped with asset management facilities, various asset management, to carry out comprehensive operation and maintenance. We are having dedicated monitoring and analysis team, which regularly do effective analysis of all our ground mounted and rooftop sites, including small plants on residential buildings from our central monitoring facilities. Here I want to mention that we are having a data logger on residential plants of 2, 3 and 5 kilowatt also. And that data we are monitoring from our central facility. We have our own transformer manufacturing unit, where we manufacture inverter transformer up to 5 MVA and up to 5 windings. Till date, we have supplied 100 plus of inverter transformers of various ratings and running successfully since last 6 years at different locations. We all know that transformer is a critical part of for any installation. It is an added advantage for any O&M company to have its own transformer workshop or facility. This is the chart which shows that average performance of all our plants from commissioning. And yes, you can say that every year we have been able to maintain consistent performance. Here are the some of the images for thermography. We are having dedicated team for all these things, thermography and module IV testing. This is the list of our esteemed customers, which includes Airport Authority of India and many banks, government sector organizations, public sector companies, bank, hotels, etc. Now we come to the opportunities. I am talking not about the rooftop, it is common for all. Design, installation and commissioning, was as previous speakers has also told, design, installation and commissioning, quality and operation maintenance, these are the four pillars of any solar plant. And we have talked till now that about the first three pillars. Now it's time to pay more attention on fourth pillar, that is operation and maintenance. Current installation of 15 plus gigawatt and coming 4-5 years it will be multiple. So it will be a very big opportunity for organized as well as unorganized player. Also, there will be a better opportunity generated for the support services like automation, skill development, security service provider. It will be a very big business for security service provider, consulting agencies, main power suppliers, local contractors for module cleaning and other works. Solar plant life span creates long-term business opportunity. I personally recommend long-term O&M contract, which is a win-win situation for both owner and the O&M service provider. Short-term contracts are just like renting a home, where vision is to complete tenure without thinking much on plant health, just to complete the tenure. And then after the tenure, it is again a challenge to hand over the assets and other liabilities to next O&M contractor. Where is long-term O&M contract? This is like owning a home, where O&M contract works like a owner and takes every care of plant health, ensure permanent corrective action. And any installation left out work, as we know that there are many installation left out work which comes over O&M, they have to complete all those works. At Ujaas, 85% of our O&M contracts are for long term with tenure of 25 years. And I am happy to share with you that some of them have successfully completed 5 years of tenure. And we have achieved more than what we have committed in 100% cases, whether it is in terms of generation or CUF. On a lighter note, you must have heard a famous dialogue, "Ek baar jo commitment kar diya, to main apne aap ki bhi nahi sunta." At Ujaas, we follow the same. Once committed, then never show your back. It is a precondition to build for long-term O&M contracts. Now we come to the challenges. Every opportunity comes with some challenges. With innovation in technology, we are now looking towards 1500 volt of DC system. And that will be a big threat for existing system of 1000 volt, because we are talking for 25 years tenure. And if technology changes, then the things which are obsolete, that spare parts availability of those will be a very big challenge in next couple of years. And policy makers must think of this to ensure that all these spare parts will be available for 25 years. If suppose some inverter gets problem after 2-3 years, and then the inverter manufacturer will not give you support for the system which is already obsolete. change in weather condition is also globally experienced, and it may deviate, as I said, it may deviate the generation from what was the estimated during the design. And major part of O&M cost includes salary and wages, what Mr. Puneet said, which is always in increasing mode. I have a data that central government has increased wages by 108% in last 1 year. I have compared the data from financial year 2016-17 and 17-18.
Mr. Rajesh, can
yeah.
you please come?
Greed, unavailability and DISCOM non-cooperation, there are some other challenges also. Change in government policy, which is a very big challenge. Then water scarcity in coming years, which is now also has been experienced. I'll end my session with this slogan, Clean India, Green India. Think solar. Think Ujaas. Thank you.